Good evening, and welcome to another edition of the Yuba Sutter Medical Explorer. My name is Dr. Robert Peppercorn, and my specialty is dermatology. I serve as host of this program. The purpose of the Medical Explorer is to explore the medical communities of Yuba and Sutter counties and to take you behind the scenes of medical care practices in our local area. We have a very interesting program for you tonight as we show you the first pictures of a new painless diagnostic technique that has just been introduced into the Marysville, Yuba City area that can locate blockages in blood vessels in our body. Also on our program tonight, the Medical Explorer would like to pay tribute to the hardworking and giving volunteers of the medical auxiliaries of the Fremont Medical Center and the Rideout Hospital. It should be a fascinating program tonight, and I hope that you'll stay with us for the next half hour. Before getting to our topics tonight, let's take a look at the latest medical news. 30 million of us will eat at fast food restaurants during the next 24 hours, and a consumer group has issued some advice on ways to make your meal healthier. A report by the Center for Science in the Public Interest in a recent issue of Nutrition Action magazine says that you can bypass high fat and salt in many foods by ordering fast food in the following ways. Ask for your Big Mac or Whopper without some trimmings such as sauce, mayonnaise, ketchup, pickles, or cheese. Order your Pizza Hut or Shakey's Pizza without the pepperoni, pork, sausage, or extra cheese. Try your McDonald's English muffin without the butter. Ask the Colonel for the original recipe instead of the extra crispy, which is also extra fatty. And finally, have your Wendy's chili without extra salt and crackers. Such changes can cut fat and salt by 10 to 40%, the group says. My next medical news story concerns recycled umbilical cords. The umbilical cord, the blood-carrying lifeline that bonds mother and infant, is now being recycled and used to replace diseased and damaged arteries. So far, more than 20,000 people have had umbilical vein transplants, primarily used in arms and legs, although FDA approval for use in cardiac surgery is expected soon. In my final medical news story tonight, analyzing hair samples to detect chemical imbalances in the body may be the key to controlling violent behavior, says a Chicago-based researcher. Using sophisticated devices to examine the atoms of the hair, researchers tested mineral levels in samples taken from 24 sibling pairs and 200 other individuals. Half of these groups were violent. People who had frequent episodes of violence showed high levels of zinc, sodium, and potassium, according to a research scientist. Long-time criminals had high levels of sodium and potassium and low levels of zinc and copper. About 40 of the human subjects have begun nutrition supplement treatments to correct the chemical imbalance. The chemical levels in about 25% dramatically improved in 1 week. Only time will tell if this treatment will have an effect on the violent behavior. In my health tip tonight, I would like to remind you of the valuable free services provided by the Yuba Sutter Colusa County Medical Society. If you need assistance in finding a doctor to assist you, and you don't know where to turn for help, then you should consider calling the County Medical Society for advice. They will quickly provide you with a list of doctors who can assist you with your health problems, and their services are free. They can also give you information on your doctor's educational background and training. Remember, the Yuba Sutter Colusa County Medical Society is available to serve you. Feel free to call for information at 673-6894. Now, on with the Medical Explorer. Two volunteer organizations that rarely get the attention and thanks that they deserve are the Medical Auxiliary Volunteers of the Rideout Hospital and the Fremont Medical Center. These thoughtful and giving citizens of our area, sometimes referred to as Pink Ladies, have donated more than 100,000 hours of volunteer assistance to the patients and staff of our area's major hospitals. Let's travel over to the Fremont Medical Center in Yuba City and explore the activities of the Fremont Medical Center Auxiliary. I'm standing now in the conference room of the Fremont Medical Center with the president of the volunteer services, I guess otherwise known as the Medical Auxiliary, Darnell Howe. Thank you for being with us today.
Thank you.
I think the community really needs to know what goes on behind the scenes in the hospital with volunteer services. Well, I know when I've been a patient myself and when I come into the hospital as a physician that many things are happening with the ladies, I often call pink ladies, in the hospital doing things for patients. Tell us, what are some of the activities that you do in the hospital?
Well, to start with, this is our group of ladies that makes our puppets for the pediatrics ward.
So these are toys that the children will use when they're in the hospital?
Well, they get to take them home. And the ladies have been making these since we were organized in 1959. And the older children get the little puppet, and the smaller babies that are back in pediatrics get the frog.
Now, I notice that whenever we come into the lobby of the hospital, there's always a volunteer at the main desk. So there's some type of informational service that you're providing. What exactly goes on there?
Well, we give the visitors the room numbers, help the families.
So when a patient or when a family member of a patient comes into the hospital and they don't know where to go, you could tell them exactly where to go from that list of information that you have.
That's right.
Mm-hmm. What else do you do regarding messenger services and things like that in the hospital?
Well, we do all kinds of errands for all the certain different stations in the hospital, lab work and x-ray. We take all the work to and from the different...
One department to another.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Now, you showed me yesterday some very interesting information about the past history of the organization. There are members here who've spent more than 4,000 hours of volunteer work. I noticed yourself, you've got over 3,100 hours of volunteer work. Is that right?
Yeah, that's true.
How many years has that been going on?
Since 1975.
I think that's fantastic, and this is all strictly volunteer work. No one's getting paid for it at all.
No, that's true.
Now, other doctors in the hospital have told me that your organization has helped raise money to buy equipment in the hospital as well. How do you go about doing that?
To buy equipment?
Right.
The administration gives us ideas of what is needed for the hospital, and then we vote on it at our board meetings. So
where does the money actually come from?
From the proceeds from the gift shop.
So your department, the volunteer services, runs the gift shop as well?
That's true. Mm-hmm.
Are there any other fundraising activities?
No, that's basically it, the gift shop.
So I also noticed that over the past 20 years, your organization's raised almost $250,000, which you've put back into the hospital.
Yes, we have. We're very proud of that.
What kind of equipment have you purchased?
Oh, all kinds of
different analyzing type things.
That's true.
Pediatrics.
Incubators.
Right.
Lots of things for the nursery. And
We had a show about 3 or 4 months ago in the intensive care nursery, and they told us there was some equipment back there that your organization had provided for the hospital.
Yes, that's true.
Mm-hmm. Mrs. Parker, I understand that you've put a tremendous amount of hours into the volunteer services here. How many hours has that been?
Well, it's over 2,000. It's on the downstairs. My name is up there, how many I have put in.
It's many thousands of hours. How many years have you?
I started working when it first started as Pink Ladies.
I think it's fantastic.
Yes,
where do you live? Are you in Yuba City or Marysville?
Oh, yeah, I'm in Yuba City.
Yuba City, great. And I understand Mrs. Green has put in many thousands of hours as well. How many hours have you actually?
4,300.
4,300 hours.
Yeah.
That's fantastic. And you didn't get paid for any of that.
No.
What do you like about that? What things motivate you to want to put that much time into the work?
Oh, I don't know. It's a satisfaction, I think, to give of your time.
I think it's fantastic.
Yes.
Do patients ever express their pleasure with the work that the organization...
The patients don't, but the doctors do, and doctors and nurses.
That's great. Well, thank you very much for letting us talk to you today.
You're welcome.
Great. And this is our pediatric playroom. We've purchased all these toys for the children to play with.
Is this volunteer here?
This is Norma Krampitz, our first vice president.
And what's she doing? Is she helping children?
I think she's helping Melissa here. She's...
So we're right next to the main pediatric ward, right out the door where we just came in.
Right. Uh-huh.
And while children are in the hospital, they can come in here and use the different toys to make their stay a little more pleasant.
That's true. Mm-hmm.
Is it true that your department has had helped purchase some of the toys here?
Well, we've bought all of these toys, and we have a red wagon, which we take the children down to X-ray and do their lab work, and that's fun for them.
And even a television set. Did you help pay for that, too?
Yes, I believe we did.
That's fantastic.
Yes, and all the books.
We should turn on and watch our Medical Explorer right now, but it's not until the evening, so we can't do that. Well, all this money, I guess, does come from the gift shop area, so what I'd like to do is head out to the gift shop and actually see where that area actually is and what goes on there, okay?
Okay, fine.
Great. Well, we've just entered the lobby, and I see this very nice desk and shop here. This is the volunteer-run gift shop, is that right?
Yes, it is. Mm-hmm.
And all these people behind the counter are part of your organization.
Yes. Mm-hmm. This is all new, this desk
counter
area. We sort of redesigned it for our candy and our jewelry and our gift shop area.
So this is the place where you're able to use part of your services to raise money for the hospital. And much of the equipment, we walked by a plaque that commemorated all of the equipment. Hundreds of things you purchased have come from this shop right here.
That's right.
Mm-hmm. Great. Thank you very much for allowing us to see this today. I really enjoyed this, and I really feel the community needs to know and really should appreciate the fantastic work of your organization. Thank you very much.
Thank you for coming and visiting us.
It's been my pleasure.
Okay.
The members of the medical auxiliaries of Rideout and Fremont perform extremely useful and helpful functions in our medical care system. The next time that you're visiting patients and friends at Fremont and Rideout, why don't you go up to one of these volunteer pink ladies and express your thanks for their superb volunteer work? Let's switch